Committee. I want to thank you for holding this hearing during a critical moment in Haiti's history. My name is Emmanuela Douyon, and I'm honored to be here on behalf of nupad, a collective of engaged Haitian citizens in the struggle against government corruption and impunity. Today is not the first time the United States Congress or his committee has held a hearing to assess U.S. policy in Haiti and gather recommendations. However, we see the present situation as fundamentally different. Today, I'm hopeful that the Haitian people are on the verge of a new era, one with new actors and a clear roadmap to end all practices that perpetrate crisis after crisis and that can instead lead to the real change the Haitian people deserve. In Haiti, we are hopeful that the administration of U.S. President Joe Biden will also break with the past and instead listen to the voices of civil society. In my written testimony, I describe the current crisis and provide a couple of recommendations that I summarize here. We believe that the Biden administration and U.S. Congress should take the following actions. The U.S. should recognize that the situation in Haiti today as a struggle by the Haitian people to take ownership of their government and build democracy, not simply a fight between politicians for power. The U.S. should not be supporting Jovenel Moïse, who is a threat to Haiti's institution and the rule of law because of his tolerance for impunity and unconstitutional and authoritarian acts, including preparation of a constitutional referendum in violation of the amendment process set forth in the Constitution, the appointment by decree of a provisional electoral council whose members are not sworn in as legally required, the recent dismissal and subsequent replacement of three Supreme Court judges, attempt to undermine the controlling power of the Court of Auditors, absence of political will to hold accountable those involved in massacres such as the La Saline massacre and several killings that happened during President Moses' term, including the devastating assassination last year of the president of the Bar Association of Port-au-Prince, Montfelier Duval. His continued effort to grab power, whatever the cost, and clear attempt to consolidate power with no checks and balances, including the replacement of elected local officials by people accountable to him only, and unconstitutional decrees that raise serious concerns. The U.S. government must recognize that, in the current context, with state-sponsored gang violence, human rights abuses, increasing authoritarianism, an unconstitutional and illegal provisional electoral council, and the failure to register voters, free, fair, and credible elections cannot be safely conducted within this year. It is simply not possible. The recurrent electoral crisis and subsequent political crisis have eroded citizen faith in their government. Rather than take sides in a constitutional dispute, it will be more helpful to listen to and offer solidarity with the Haitian people, who no longer recognize Jovenel Moïse as their president, even before his constitutional mandate ended, after years of calling on him to resign, following reports from the Court of Auditors, proving his involvement in the Petro-Caribe corruption scandal, and his other deeply concerning human rights abuses. Corrupt, incompetent, and authoritarian officials should never be allowed to stay in power beyond their term in the name of democracy. The U.S. government should recognize that past foreign-led attempts aimed to strengthen democracy in Haiti have not led to progress and have even been counterproductive. It is time to follow the lead of Haitian civil society in determining when to support elections in Haiti and respect their current effort to solve the crisis as they want to. Specifically, by organizing a non-partisan, non-corrupt, consensus-based team of civil society and political actors capable of ensuring the governance of the country, filling the institutional void at the head of the country since the end of President Moses' constitutional mandate on February 7, 2021, and restore democratic order. The U.S. will investigate money laundering and arms trafficking, human rights abuses and other illegal acts by Haitian officials and private sector leaders and apply sanctions, including under the Global Magnitsky Act, where applicable. It is time to send a clear signal to those who are squandering state resources with impunity and those who continue to shed blood and violate human rights. The United States should support Haitian civil society's call for the immediate release of those arrested on February 7, 2021, and not give credence to the government's narrative, given the lack of credible evidence of a coup attempt. To conclude, I want to state clearly that the people of Haiti are resolute in their desire for a true democracy, a democracy that works for all, and need to be able to count on the support of their friends and partners, including the U.S. government in this pursuit. Thank you very much, and I look forward to your questions.